We live in the age of AI. Most AI tools are now based on large language models. Today, we'll explore how to perform data analysis using the PandasAI tool locally. Let's take a look at what we'll cover in this video. First, we'll briefly explain what PandasAI is. Next, we'll load our dataset. After that, we'll get a large model with Ollama. Lastly, we'll analyze data with this model. Keep in mind that to work with the large model, we will not use any API key, such as the OpenAI API key. This means that the analysis we'll do is completely local and free. Let's dive in. What we're gonna do now is look at PandasAI. PandasAI is nothing but a Python tool. You can talk to your data using this tool. It allows you to explore, clean, and analyze your data using generative AI. Overall, using PandasAI, it's very easy to perform your data analysis projects. Okay, we've seen what PandasAI is. Let's go ahead and start the setup for our project. Now, we're gonna create a virtual environment. To do this, we're gonna use Conda. Let's open the VS Code terminal and write Conda create. To give a name, let's use dash n and then let's name GenAI. I already created this. After creating our environment, we're gonna activate this. Let's do this with Conda. Conda activate GenAI. Okay, our environment is ready to use. What we're gonna do now is install the tools we'll use. To do this, let's create a requirement.txt file. We're gonna click on the new file and then name it requirements.txt. After that, let's write the tool we'll use here. To read our dataset, we'll use PandasAI. To import Ollama, we'll leverage LangChain. Let me type LangChain and then LangChain community. For now, these tools are enough to analyze the data. Now, we're gonna install this. Pip install -r requirements.txt. Yeah, loading started. There you go. Our tools are ready to use. To write our codes, we're gonna create a notebook file. Let me click on the new file and then give a name. Let's say pandasai.ipynb. After that, let's select kernel. To do this, let me click on the Python environment and then select GenAI. It's time to read our data. To load the data, we're gonna use pandas. First, let's import this library. Import pandas as pd. The dataset we're gonna use is country population. You can find a link to this dataset in the description below. Let's have a look at this dataset. This dataset includes the population of several countries. What we're gonna do now is read this dataset with the read CSV method. Let's say data equals pd.readcsv and then let's pass the name of our dataset population.csv. Okay, our dataset is ready to dive in. Let's take a look at the first file of the data. To do this, we're gonna use the head method data.head. There you go. You can see countries and populations. Nice, our dataset is ready. What we're gonna do now is initialize the model. To do this, we're gonna use Ollama. To leverage Ollama, you need to install it. To install this tool, go to Ollama website and then click on the download button. After installing this tool, you can use it in your terminal. Let me show you the version of Ollama. Let's write Ollama --version. There you go. To load a model, you can use the pull command. To see the models you can leverage, you can click the models. There you go. Here are many models you can use. For this tutorial, we're gonna utilize the Mr. model. Let's pull this model. To do this, go to our terminal and then write Ollama pull Mr. There you go. Our model is ready to use. What we're gonna do now is import Ollama from LangChain community. Let's write from LangChain community and then write LLMs import Ollama. Now, let's initialize our model. Let's say LLM equals Ollama. Let's pass model Mistral. Awesome. Our model is ready. To talk to our dataset, we're gonna use the Smart Data Frame class. This class allows you to interact with a single data frame. First, let's import this class from PandasAI import Smart Data Frame. After that, let's convert our dataset into Smart Data Frame using this class df equals Smart Data Frame. Let's pass our data and then let's set the config parameter. Let me set LLM. It's gonna be our LLM variable over here. Nice! Our Smart Data Frame is ready. Let's go ahead and start to chat with our data. The first question we're gonna ask is to find the top 5 countries by population. Let's write df dot, let's call the chat method, and then let's write which are the top 5 countries by population. Let's run this cell. There you go. You can see the top 5 countries by population here. It's important to keep in mind that we don't use any API key. We just leverage an open source model from Ollama. This means that we perform this analysis locally and for free. Great! We've seen the top 5 countries by population. Let's go ahead and find the total populations of the top 5 countries. Let's write df chat. Let's pass. What is the total populations of the top 5 countries by population? Let's run this cell. There you go. That was easy, right? You can explore your data with the prompts like this. Yeah, that's it. In this video, we've covered how to perform data analysis with PandasAI and Ollama. Using these AI tools, you can do your data analysis projects locally and for free. If you have any questions, let me know. The link to this notebook is in the description. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.